In this video lecture, we'll take a look at how to begin adding instance variables to our new person class. Okay, let's get started. The instance variables, or fields, of any class are simply its data, or its software description of what the class is. The data is just some internal collection of related variables which, taken together, describe the current state of any object instance of that class. They are typically declared at the beginning of any class, and this is critical, outside of any methods. The data are just regular variables or objects, all of which follow the usual naming conventions, camel case naming, descriptive names, and so forth. In particular, instance variables, like any other variables, always start with lowercase letters to clearly distinguish them from class names, which by good convention always begin with capital letters. Instance variables can be any one of the 8 core Java data types, or object instances of any Java-provided class, such as string, or object instances of any user-defined class, such as CS12Date. We'll be using both of these in our person class. This next item is crucial. In any well-designed Java class, instance variables always carry a private access specifier, which prevents any random outside alteration of their values. The only outside access to instance variables is through specific, well-defined channels, their public accessors and mutators. By observing these conventions, classes keep their instance data tightly protected. The nice thing about instance variables is that they have class scope, which means that they are visible to all methods of the class, public or private. So all methods work with one commonly visible copy of the instance data. And even better, we don't have to pass instance variables into or out of methods, nor do we have to declare them if we want to use them. Their one single declaration at the head of their class is all the declaration they require, and thereafter we have free class-wide access to them. So properly created instance variables are global within their class, but invisible to the outside world. Here's a table showing all the access modifiers in Java. Although there are 4 possible access modifiers, we are only going to concern ourselves with these first two, public and private. These access modifiers can be applied to both types of class members, instance variables and methods, which we'll see a bit later. The short and sweet of it is that public instance variables or methods are visible or usable by code outside the class, while private instance variables or methods are not visible or usable by code outside the class. They are only usable inside their class. Again, in a well-designed class, we typically have private instance variables accessible only via public accessors and mutators. These other two access modifiers, protected and package, we won't cover in this course, but they're listed here for completeness. So to keep things very simple, for now we are only going to set up the first one of the required API instance variables in our person class, and here's how we go about it. For any instance variable we create, we declare it as private, declare its data type or class type as always, and then give it a name per our desired API. For now, we're going to add just this one instance variable to our person class. Once we have this first one in place, along with all its upcoming added infrastructure, we're going to find that adding additional ones later on is absolutely trivial. So we'll get the first instance variable in place, plus all the methods it needs, then come back later on to clone the additional instance variables and methods needed. This again represents that start simple and add on gradually software development paradigm. It will feel slow at first, but it's going to pay dividends in the end. This is the approach I want you to take in building your class. And note how we're using an inline comment here to document this instance variable's purpose. We can also use this to document its units or any other info. This is just another little good software practice. Finally, remember that in our initial person class setup, we added pseudocode placeholders for other types of data. It turns out that not all of the data we might want to have on hand in our class is necessarily a true instance variable. There might be some data intended for internal use only, so we would probably declare these as private, but they'd still be usable throughout the entire class. Furthermore, if this kind of supporting data is private, there's also no need for any accessors or mutators for them, since they don't require any outside access. Some examples of such private internal data might be things like scanner objects for user input, any kind of internal program constants or conversion factors, or maybe some type of format specifiers for standard output formatting. We'll gradually add some of these as we build up our new person class. Just as a reminder, we're only going to set up one instance variable for now. Once we have this pattern in place for one, we're going to see later how easy it will be to extend this to all the other instance variables needed. To finish up, please view the demo video for person-phase-2.java, where we'll make the next set of changes to our person class and save the next incremental set of changes. Okay, that's it for the moment on instance variables.